Well, let's do it.
All right.
I played Survivor Kagyan, and I have a phenomenal social game. I'm a police officer, so I can read people. And with a season called Game Changers, I feel like somebody will get anxious and feel as though they need to make a move, which will put a target on their back. And then I'm going to be the silent assassin.
Same on my part.
I told Sari I'm good with her, but if someone's gonna throw her name out, I'm gonna go with it. Last time I played like a cop, look where it got me. This time I'm playing like a criminal, and we'll see where it gets me. My word is not my bond in this game this time.
Tavua, who started literally from scratch, has somehow banded together, and we're just like dominating stuff now.
Peanut butter and Survivor, that's like gold.
But I don't want to be overconfident. In the event that something crazy happens, I need options.
Best on this tribe.
Okay. I think you're doing something because the girls will get real suspicious.
At this point, Troy Zan's the odd one out against me and the other four. But the set four, that's stupid. That's boring. I don't like it. Let's grow up. Come on.
This is a feel-out, can we trust each other time right now. If you say anything about us talking, you're a dead man, I'm a dead woman.
I'm completely playing this game like a criminal this time. I know how criminals lie to me, so I know how to lie to these people.
I'm gonna look for an idol, but you better never happen. You been there, done that.
The reason Sandra has won twice is because she doesn't come off as the most dangerous person in this game. I almost feel like the way Sandra talks to people is she's grooming us. She doesn't pressure you, her voice never raises, it's calm, and she just starts to suck you in.
I mean, Sandra's so good, like.
Today, after the reward, Varner starts saying, I really wanna work with you guys, and I think we can pull Varner and actually use him as a number, and I really truly feel like we've made that connection.
So, do you have your eyes on anyone that you want to get rid of first, or do you not care and we can let everyone else decide?
I want to get rid of Ozzy.
You do?
I do.
Okay.
Just so we all have a fighting chance. I'm sick of watching Survivor where all these A-alpha
like
dudes get to
everything.
The end,
yeah.
And people like us just sort of sit there and hope he loses. I don't want that. I'd like to win that necklace every now and then.
I know. I want to win one.
Then he says, could Ozzy potentially be the vote? So that's what I'm thinking of right now. I need to be careful because that's a huge move, but I'm ready to prove why I am a game changer.
This is elimination number 7, and that's where you start ticking off the big physical threats.
Mm-hmm.
I'm good. I'm great.
We're close to emerge, and we need to take out who is the biggest threat. It might be time to cut Ozzy's throat. Zeke sat him down and said, the girls are gonna lie to you just to make you feel good. And I'm like, what? Why would you throw us under the bus so you could save face? Things are starting to look weird now. Zeke doesn't really want to get rid of Ozzy, and Zeke threw Andrea and I under the bus. I'm like, this kind of is starting to stink. Do Zeke and Ozzy have something more going on that I don't know about? And that really scares me. This could be a huge mistake, but maybe we need to get rid of Ozzy and keep Varner.
About it.
You know, I come from a very conservative background. I don't know any transgender people until now. And the fact that I've been with Zeke and gotten to know him as a person from day one, I love that guy. And it doesn't change who he is to me. If anything, it makes us stronger, I feel. So I woke up this morning and Zeke is Zeke.
Oh my God.
We lost the Marshall's spa day, and it's a huge letdown, but I'm finding myself in the middle. I have options, and it's just gonna be which group wants to vote out the person that I wanna vote out. That's where I'm gonna go. At this point, I am sitting in the middle of two groups that are starting to surface. The one group, Brad, Sierra, Troy Zan, Ty, Debbie, they want to vote out Ozzy. And then there's another group of Sari, Andrea, Michaela, Aubrey, and Ozzy. And they want to see Zeke go. I'm weighing out all my options. And to vote Ozzy out, that means taking out a big social and challenge threat right now. That's the move to make early on in a merge. But then, a lot of people want Zeke out because he's a smart guy and he's willing to make moves. And when you trust somebody like that, you will end up getting blindsided. So it's a real tough position to be in, but a line will be drawn in the sand, this vote. At Tribal Council, I had to pick a side, but I still want to work with Zeke. Having Zeke opens up options for me.
I knew you were going to be okay. I just couldn't fill you in on everything because I need them to trust me. So I'm sorry I left you out of it.
It's okay, I understand. And
as much as people want to think that the line's drawn in the sand, well, I hate to break it to people, but the tide comes up pretty quickly and that line gets washed away. I'm looking over at Michaela and I see a rolled up piece of paper that says secret advantage. And I can't believe Michaela didn't see that. With Survivor, to be a game changer, you gotta be looking constantly for idols and clues, and now I have a secret advantage. So this is a huge win for me. When we were leaving the challenge, I looked over at Michaela and I see a secret advantage right at her feet. That's called attention to detail. I'm a police officer, but the normal person that drives down the road would not know if the car in front of them's registration tags are expired or not. I would.
Congratulations, you've found an advantage in this game. You now have the right to steal a vote from someone at Tribal Council. Holy.
Having this advantage opens up options for me. I can completely flip the game.
This vote is non-transferable and cannot be stolen from you. The last time this extra vote can be cast is when there are five people left in the game.
In the past, these extra votes have not been played correctly. I will be the first one to play this vote correctly. I promised myself coming out here that I will not make the same mistakes I made the first time I played. What I did in Cagayan was look for the safest route I could go. I sat back, didn't make a move, and let other people make the decisions. That didn't work. It got me on the jury and not even close to a shot at $1 million. There's small windows of opportunities in this game, and if you miss them, you're not gonna win. However, this game is all about timing, and I'm not sure the time is right to make a big move, but I'm ready for it in the event that it is.
We're all good.
We're good.
The plan was made without even asking me, and I realized at that point, I'm not high in the pecking order in that six-sum, so it might be time for me to make my move.
But at the end, I think it's me, you, and Debbie. We're the final three.
I had this plan to blindside the power group, and then Sierra proposes this idea that me, her, and Debbie are a final three. And I was like, holy crap. Maybe I'm not on the bottom of the six at all. I was thinking I might want to sit in the final three with Debbie. But now she's spreading lies about me.
We have your back, I swear to you.
Okay.
At this point, I don't know what to do. If I can control Debbie, I could be in the top six for sure, potentially in the final three.
Do you understand the predicament I'm in?
Yeah.
It's really hard to leave safety for the unknown.
However, I swore to myself coming out here, I'm gonna make big moves.
She's the kid.
She knows it too.
Whatever I do, it's gonna determine how far I go in this game. I'm gonna decide at Tribal.
Anybody wants to talk to me?
Tonight at Tribal Council, I was the deciding vote in which alliance was gonna get the majority of the numbers.
Out of curiosity, why'd y'all choose Debbie?
She seemed like she was the one in charge.
You know, this is Survivor. It's game changers. Hopefully, if I make it to the end, the jury will reward the fact that I was a game changer enough to make this type of a move. I've never been in a helicopter. Super stoked. I get a window seat.
Fiji.
It's a dream come true. I mean, it's insane how many islands and how beautiful they are. The helicopter lands, basically red carpet rolled out. There's a guy waiting with drinks for us.
Hola.
When Sari presents the idea of getting rid of Zeke, I'm definitely not down for it. Because I can trust Zeke. So I need to reassure her to keep him in this game as long as I can. I need to fill her in on what my secret advantage is. Typically in Survivor, you don't want to show your cards, but sometimes it's necessary to lock people in.
The reason I'm not concerned, because I'm going to tell you what backup is.
What is it?
The advantage is a steal a vote.
What do you mean, a steal a vote?
Steal a vote. I get a vote again.
Wow. Okay.
And here's the thing. The smaller in numbers we get, the easier it is to get Zeke out.
Right.
But Zeke, you're only getting the six, buddy.
Okay.
I feel pretty good with Sari. I think it completely calmed her and smoothed over the situation. But in the event that they want to flip the script, I could jump ship next vote and go back and work with Troyzan and Brad and Sierra and Ty, because I want to go with whatever side can get me further in the game.
We can make it to the end.
All right.
But
we're going to stick with the plan, so it's going to be Sierra.
I find myself sitting in the middle, which again, works perfect for me. So I'm going to let the plans develop. And then I'm going to pick a side. I feel good with Zeke. We've been together since day one. And right now, we're staying with the girls. But at the end of the day, I don't trust them. I trust Zeke.
I think that our...
Just because Andrea's got a little bit of power now, she's talking about potentially taking out Zeke this vote. I'm definitely not down for it. I need Zeke for a few more votes, but I really need to keep my mouth shut, because if I start scrambling around to try to save Zeke, I'm gonna get in hot water. Tonight is now about Sierra versus Zeke. This vote for our alliance is a huge decision, because right now it's 6-4. We vote out one of our own, it's 5-4. One person flips over, they've got the numbers.
I have to put my vote down. Tonight we find out if this 6 stays together.
Okay.
But at the same time, if I press the issue of keeping Zeke, they're gonna think I have an ulterior motive, they're not gonna trust me, and trust is everything in this game. So I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I have a feeling the deciding vote's gonna come down to Michaela and me. Brad and Sierra need to be split up, and when Sierra told me about this advantage, it actually makes me want to keep her now, because she's giving me information and she wants to work with me. So the door is opening for her to stay in this game, and Brad's game is over. So originally, I didn't want to vote Sierra out, but Brad won immunity. And if Sierra goes, it is not all bad, because Sierra has told me about this legacy advantage and that she would will it to me if she leaves. Now the only trick is I need to confirm that Sierra thinks I'm good with her to ensure that she gives it to me.
I mean, it's us, right?
I love you. You're my, like, it girl out here. Like,
I'm with
on
you.
A real level.
Right.
I don't want to vote her out, but this isn't about making friends. This is about winning $1 million. So now, according to Sierra, Ty and Michaela might be voting out Andrea, which is news to me. I need them to help me vote Sierra out, because I need that advantage. Last night at Tribal, taking out Sierra was good, because she told me about this legacy advantage. She said, in the event that she is voted out, she's going to will it to me. So at Tribal Council, as her name comes up, I look at her in shock, like, I can't believe you're going. And it worked. And Sierra willed me her advantage. You have found the legacy advantage. With this note in your possession, you are guaranteed immunity, but it comes with a twist. You may only use it once when there are 13 people left in the game, or when there are only 6 people left in the game. And now I have 2 advantages. The first one is a steal a vote, which amounts to 2 votes. And the second one is the legacy. So this time, game changers. I'm shooting for the stars here. And if I had to pick, I want Andrea gone. I cannot stand the girl. However, it's got to be the right time. For whatever reason, Ceree wants to believe Aubrey and everything that's coming out of Aubrey's mouth.
I believe Ty over Aubrey. I really do. And you know what?
Mm-hmm.
This is what I'll do.
Mm-hmm.
I will give you my advantage.
Mm-hmm.
Because if I get voted out, mm-hmm. then at least you've got it.
Okay. Me.
So I'm going to give Ceree the advantage of steal a vote to hold on to. This way, if this doesn't scream loyal, I don't know what does.
We all game again.
I deserve to be a game changer. I didn't leave my son for 39 days to not win $1 million. I felt betrayed by Ceree at Tribal Council playing my steal a vote. So I targeted Michaela because Michaela is Ceree's right-hand man. But now, I don't know who I can trust. Fortunately, I still have the legacy advantage, which can be played at 6, so I know I'm safe. That was given the drama that happened at the last tribal council, I'm not really sure where I stand with people. And this reward is what I needed. I gotta find out who's willing to go to the end with me. And I'm gonna do whatever I have to do to solidify my spot. I've got the legacy advantage, and nobody knows about it. So I'm lucky that I'm safe tonight. But at this point, I have to go with people that are gonna take me to the end. I felt betrayed by Ceree at Tribal Council, and Ty, I clearly can't trust him. So the only choice I have right now is to go with Brad and Troy.
I agree.
The story of my game this whole season is I'm always in the middle. So, I've got a decision to make tonight. But first, I need to make sure that I can trust Ty.
Could flip on him tonight.
Tonight is huge. This could be a $1 million move. And sure enough, Ty's changing his mind again at the last minute. Tonight is actually the biggest vote of the game. It's going to determine who will be in the final four. So, Ty and I have to figure out which way to go. Today is one of the most nerve-wracking days. Everybody wants to get to the end, so everybody's lobbying for themselves. Every scenario is crossing my mind at this point in time, and I need to make sure people are going to choose me to go to the end. Over the course of the conversation with Troyzan, it has become clear that Brad and Troyzan probably won't split up. They'll protect each other to the end. So do they want to work with me? I don't know. Now it's fight for your life. It's no longer an alliance game, and it is an individual game, and you do what you need to do to get to the end, period. Brad and Troyzan have been tight the entire game, so clearly they're going to make a move against me or Ty. So when he said, let's vote for Troyzan and force a tie, which would come down to a fire-making challenge, I have to consider it. Even though it scares the crap out of me, I'm not super good at fire.
I don't think Troyzan's very good at making fire.
Yeah, probably not.
No. I think we could do it.
Brad's pretty cocky right now and thinks he's calling the shots. But I'm thinking, screw that. If I can win a fire-making challenge, I can decide who's going to the final three.
Jerry hate me. They do, because I appear like a liar. I just have that feeling.
Yeah.
I don't think I'm a good player.
Yeah.
Ty's telling me that he can't win, but he's made moves and found 3 idols, so he has a resume. However, Ty's so all over the place, he might have alienated the jury. And then there's Troyzan, who hasn't done anything without Brad's permission this whole game. But at the same time, he hasn't made anyone mad. And Sandra won twice by not making anyone mad.
How do you start it? Like, what do you need to do?
So, when you make fire, make a nest.
Okay.
Shape a thing.
Okay.
Watch the wind.
I think I can do it.
If I do this and win, I could rack up a ton of points with the jury. But I have to decide if this is a risk that I'm willing to take. It's a coin flip, and I gotta pick heads or tails.
Final three.
Knowing that I am in the final three is the best feeling in the world.
This is a good meal right here.
It's what you dream of when Jeff says the word go on day one.
You guys are gonna wanna eat pancakes.
I worked my butt off to get here. I made moves that other people were scared to make. I made moves that I was scared to make. And I'm very proud of how I played.
Brad, are you even nervous about tonight?
Not really.
As a police officer, I don't respect being lied to. It makes me feel like you think that I'm stupid. But I'm the criminal tonight, and those people on the jury are the police officers. So if they're asking for the truth, I'm going to give them the truth because I reward honesty. I hope they reward my honesty tonight.